Hey, 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 everyone. This is Blockchain Bernie here with my latest episode right from fabulous Las Vegas. And this is about an update on the Solana congestion issues. So if you haven't heard about it, here's my video where I talked about the congestion issues the first time and the mitigation efforts that are underway. And man, have we made progress in the meantime. So there is a new release, 1.17.31, that most validators have adopted now that mitigates a whole lot of the congestion. And then the ore mining tool has been paused in order to improve it and get a version 2 out. But the pausing of the ore mining has contributed to a lot less as well. But, you know, make no mistake, there is still a lot of spam going on. There are still a lot of guys out there that try to get their traffic to the Solana validators and, you know, do whatever they can to exploit any bugs that are there for getting their transactions through without paying a lot of fees and all these kind of things. But, you know, there is the Solana Tech Discord. And by the way, Discord is a great tool. If you haven't heard about Xandeum, we're building the scalable storage layer for the Solana chain. Go to Xandeum.com and in the top right corner of our website, join our Discord, follow us on Twitter, and collect points because we have a points program. So for everything you do there, including liking this video, including leaving a comment and subscribing to this channel, this all will give you points. So our points program is up and running, so don't forget to do all these things. But the progress on the mitigation of the congestion has been substantial, and I've been following the MB Validators channel on the Solana Tech Discord. MB Validators stands for Mainnet Beta Validators, and as you know, we here at Xandeum operate one of the highest performing Solana validators there. So if you have some Sol and you have not staked it, you're leaving money on the table. You should stake your Sol and do it with the Xandeum validator. Go to Xandeum.com and you see that stake link in the very top. So what has been happening? There is two guys out there in the MB Validators channel. One is called Zanetsu. He's the founder of Shinobi Systems, running one highly staked validator there, contributing to the Solana community like crazy. He's really a great guy. He's come out with some tools for other validators, for any validator free to use, to mitigate the congestion. So that is just awesome. He's trusting a lot on logging. So he's logging a lot of those traffic things that are coming in and then reading those logs and trying to figure out who to block and things like that. And there is another guy out there on MB Validators, Brian Long. He's the founder of Triton One. And I've met Brian first time in person, like 2 years ago in Lisbon at the Solana Breakpoint conference, had some calls with him. So I know him well, and he's been contributing like crazy in the Solana Tech Discord for mitigating these congestion issues, right? And what he is doing is he's classifying the so-called TPU traffic, right? So TPU means transaction processing unit, right? So there's two things in Solana: the transaction processing unit, TPU, and then there's the TVU, the transaction validation unit, right? So the TPU is for producing blocks, generating blocks. That's what the leader does, right? So there's a leader schedule, and each validator becomes the leader at some point in time. The more stake the validator has, the more often they become the leader. There's that leader schedule, and there's the TPU, that's where the blocks are being produced, and the TVU, where the blocks are being validated. So Brian Long has created a tool to classify the incoming traffic into the TPU, because that's where the spammers, send their instructions to, right? Usually you should go through an RPC node. An RPC node is a validator by its own right. And it is in gossip, right? So that means it has joined the community of validators, so to speak, and is communicating with other validators in that gossip protocol. So that's what it usually takes. But then, you know, these spammers, they don't go through RPC nodes, right? They just look at the leader schedule, which is a public thing. I mean, Solana is a public permissionless blockchain, right? And it's great that it is that way. But that also means anyone can read the leader schedule and can just send transactions to the leader, circumventing any RPC nodes. That is perfectly fine. That's by design. Solana is designed that way. But what happens usually is it's those guys that trying to spam the network that won't pay high fees for their transactions, just try to get through, paying almost no fees, and just trying to do some arbitrage and things like that. I'm not saying any of this is kind of bad in itself, but it's contributing to the congestion. And for the validator, it means the validator has to process a lot of transactions that in the end don't result in fee-paying transactions. And that's what the validator wants to do. We want to generate a high yield for you, for stake, if you stake your soul with us, right? And so again, we have our own Xandeum validator. It's, you know, it has 477,000 sol in stake. So it's kind of a medium stake there, but it's quite substantial. I'm quite proud of that. And it's not in the very high range. And that would be bad because if you stake with a super high staked validator, you're not contributing to decentralization, right? And if you stake with a super low staked validator, then you might stake your soul with kind of a rookie or someone that's not that committed and might be gone tomorrow, right? So that medium stake thing is kind of a sweet spot, I feel. And with our validator, you know, we're committed to get you the most, the highest yield. That's why we charge 0% commission still. If you have some sol, you need to stake it, please use the Xandeum validator for that. 0% commission. And we have adopted that tool, right? And our team member, Xandeum team member Brad, has worked with Brian. So thanks again, Brad, for doing all that and helping us getting that tool implemented. And that tool is called TPU Traffic Classifier. So we have it right here, and it's written by Brian Long. It's the TPU Traffic Classifier, and it just listens to the traffic at the TPU port. So it's released open source, right? So anyone is free to use it. And with that tool, we can see which IP addresses send us requests for transactions on our TPU port. And then we can classify that, is that coming from IP addresses that participate in gossip? So those are the real guys that, you know, are really part of the Solana network in a sense, right? But there are some unstaked ones that are not really committed. There are some really low-staked ones. And that tool classifies that, right? And then Drops is able to create firewall rules that drops the packages that come from these potential low-paying spammers out there, right? And letting through only the legit traffic. And man, does that help, right? So for us, it has helped us get the block rewards for a validator up 2.5x, right? And I know a lot of other validators that are kind of befriended validators that have reported something between 2.2 and 3.1x, right? Not talking percent here. I'm talking of 3x, right? So suddenly the block rewards for that same validator go up by 3x just by implementing that tool. So thanks, Brian, for working on that. And thanks, Brad, for implementing it for our Xandeum validator, right? So that means the 3x's are block rewards. The block rewards is not what goes back to stakers. For stakers, it's kind of the APY that is happening through through the inflation thing on the Solana chain. So we pay you back everything of that, right? So we're charging 0% commission for over a year now. We intend to keep it that way. And even with the upcoming liquid staking pool that Xandeum is building and that I announced in the last video, we intend to give back a good part of our block rewards, right? That are now 3x than they were before, right? Back to you, to the stakers. But that only works with our upcoming liquid staking tool. So stay tuned, right? And with that liquid staking pool, we also give back a good part of our MEV rewards and all these type of things. So it's really going to be super exciting. And also the liquid staking pool is, you know, we only delegating to validators that have committed themselves to implement the Xandeum storage layer once it's there, with the extra rewards that come from the storage. So those go all back to you as liquid stakers. So super excited about that upcoming liquid staking pool that's there. But I'm also super excited that we have mitigations for the Solana congestion. And by the way, almost each and every transaction in the last few days and last week, I would say, has been going through. So I'm using Solana a lot for a lot of things. And, you know, like 2 weeks ago, there was some congestion, and I had to try a few transactions, like 5 or 6 times until they went through. The last 7 days or so, no problems at all, right? So if you go to the Solana Explorer, you can still see a little bit of congestion here and there, but it's gotten way better. And with these mitigation tools, especially that TPU traffic classifier, it is just awesome. It is helping us so much. And then I know the guys from Solana Labs, from Anzo, which is a spin-off of Solana Labs, they are working on the new version, on the 1.18 version that is already live in testnet, that has a lot of more mitigations and actually fixes some of the bugs. And the bugs is not really in the Solana code, right? The bug is in that Quick library. So Quick is that protocol developed by Google back in the day that makes, you know, that replaces TCP somehow, right? It builds on top of UDP and is so much faster than TCP and has a lot more properties that helps Solana limit traffic and limit bad traffic and stuff like that. And it seems the Rust implementation of Quick that the Solana guys were using, that library has a few issues there that come to light when you put things under stress. And again, all these issues we're having in the Solana chain only because Solana is in demand, because there are so many guys sending transactions and using the Solana chain, right? So it's literally the good part of growing pains that Solana is going through right now. And, you know, I'm so happy to be part of this. I'm so happy to be building on Solana, adding the scalable storage layer that's badly needed, and also optimizing our validator as we go, and having implemented that TPU traffic classifier that had such a great effect on our validator, all right? So I hope that gave you a little bit of an overview on where we're at with the Solana congestion issues. And there's still work to do, as I mentioned, but we're making progress on all fronts. So thanks so much for watching, guys. Catch you later. Peace.